Let's start working on the base. We're gonna start working on the metals first. We're gonna use the same method as we used with the blade. We're gonna crease the edges. You're gonna go to creases. You're gonna reduce this down to 2. Click D. Click again the Z modeler. There's a change that should have happened, but you don't have the smooth division levels up high enough. There we go. So now it's dynamically subdividing it so that you can visualize it, but it won't actually have the high topology. We're going to do the same thing with the others. We're going to crease. I have my tools over here, so I can just bring it down to 2. D. You want to bring this up. 6. Do it again. Dynamic. 6. This one we're just gonna subdivide normally. Oh, probably not actually. Let's get the crease. And now we're just gonna divide normally. We're not gonna really see this part since it's gonna be covered with wraps. Add some creases, 2. Okay, and think one more time, unless there's still one up there. Move this up a little bit. Okay. Do this one. Perfect. Let's pull up the concept. We're going to start by working on this shape right now. So it has kind of a peak here, and then it comes back down. Let's do that. We're going to do an insert edge loop right here. Mask the bottom, mask the top. Invert. And we're going to crease this one also. There we go. So now we're getting that nice simple shape up here. We're going to do something similar to this one, but we're just not going to crease it. There we go. get that little bump coming out. Get a little bump also here. And get a little bump again. Might have to bring this whole thing down a little bit. About to here. Should be good, I think. Seems about right. Okay. We go here. We're going to apply dynamic subdivision. We're going to go to Trim Dynamic, BTD. And we're going to start doing a little bit of sculpting. Just getting the bevels a little bit to what I want. Give it some irregularities. You know, you don't want this axe to be perfect. Oh, something that we forgot to do, we forgot to mirror it. So let's go back. Let's undo all this. Always mirror when you're doing the game object. And you have limitations in the game. Some studios you don't have to do that, but for a lot of games, mirroring is pretty important. So, just doing some edge damage. You don't want this to be too perfect. You know, it's supposed to be an axe with some wood on it, a little worn out, some fur. It'll make it look like it's been through something. So I'm doing the clay buildup, and then I'm pushing it down with Trim Dynamic, just to give it, you know, some detail here and there. Okay, it's good for that one. Let's go up here, do a little bit of the same thing, more subtle with this window. Make sure it's on Z, because I ended up making mine on Z. Probably it was a better idea to make it on X, though. Apply dynamic subdiv. And just lightly do, just do some light beveling on it. do some dinks. You know, like it's hit a few things. Let's go here, put some pretty notable ones on here too. Get up here, do the same thing. We're going to keep the center mostly clean because we're going to be putting spikes on it. We can always come back and damage it up later. Alright, we're going to rotate all this up to the x-axis. Here we go. All right. So now that'll be all a lot easier to work with. Now everything should be X'd. X-axis. Perfect. How about this one? That is still on the other one. There we go. And this should be the last one for the edge damage. Okay. We're going to start on the wraps next. If you liked my video, then don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, don't hesitate to leave a comment. Have a nice day.